There are a thousand different ways to do text when you start talking about airbrushing. I'm going to show you some of the most common tricks that the pros use to make their logos and their text pop off of projects. So, let's get started. For brushed, all you have to do is lay in just a little bit of color, then I'm going to come back with silver on top, and then brush it in. For raised text, all you have to do is put in a really light color to start off on your stencil. Now I'm going to take my originally cut out letters, put them on top of what I just painted. For distress text, go in and lay in one light layer of whatever your color is going to be. Then a little bit darker of a layer, but keep it a little uneven. Now take your Scotch-Brite pad, scratch it up. For stamped or recessed text, it's really easy. All you have to do is do a drop shadow in one direction on the inside of your letters. One of the biggest problems folks have when they start working with vinyl, and when you start cutting vinyl for small stencils, is the vinyl tends to stick to your project and peel the paint up. So one way to do it is to take a little bit of that tackiness away. And one of the easiest ways to do it is take an old t-shirt or something and just stick your vinyl on there, peel it off, stick it on there, peel it off. And what it does is it takes some of those microfibers, sticks on the back of your vinyl, and makes it just a little bit less sticky and less likely to peel up the paint. So, that's pretty much it. If you got any questions, you know where to check us out. Airbrushtricks.com. I'm Tony D. Then there are some other tricks to either bring that text in towards you or out towards you.